for a short session of how to do impromptu speaking.
Now, impromptu speaking is what they call table topics. And a lot of Toastmasters find it very challenging to actually come up in front and speak on a topic that you are not prepared for, because you're just given a topic as you come up. And there are many Toastmasters, even seasoned Toastmasters, who have this fear, probably irrational fear, about coming up and try table topics. But I'm here to tell you that table topics is really fun. It's really easy if you can focus your mind on the topic, and it's relatively easy provided you follow a simple formula. Now, table topics to seasoned Toastmasters, or in a contest format at Toastmasters International, is actually what we call a mini speech. So if it's a mini speech, you start off with an introduction, which means in any speech, your first 3 seconds to 5 seconds of your speech is very important, because that's where your audience will decide whether they want to listen to you or not, or they'll switch off. And that is important because you have to engage them from 1 to 2 minutes. And then you have your body, because it's a mini speech, your body will have probably 2 points. And then you have the conclusion, which you either reprise the whole speech in 1 or 2 sentences, or you provided added value by giving some moral or some learning so that there is speech value. So in that sense, it's like a speech that you make, your 5 to 7 minute speech. But for new Toastmasters, it's not about getting agitated or getting apprehensive about doing a mini speech, because you are not ready for it. It will take time. So for a new Toastmasters, it is all right if you don't speak on the topic. It's okay if you digress and talk about something else. It's okay if you say, all right, I don't know about that topic, I'm going to talk about myself, or I'm going to talk about my dog or my cat. It's all right. Because the whole purpose of table topics in a table topics meeting is about coming up here and have that courage to speak for just 1 minute in front of an audience, whether it's your fellow club members or an audience of Toastmasters whom you may or may not be familiar with. And that's the challenge. The benefit is building confidence. Now, of course, if you are getting better at table topics, to build that confidence, you need only 2 things. One is, you must have your own self-confidence. You have lots of it. You can just come up here and speak. Whether it's right or wrong, it doesn't matter. Because it's about displaying your confidence. That's all there is to it. Because in speeches, there is no right or wrong. Because in table topics, there are no objectives for you to follow. So who is the evaluator to say, I don't understand your speech, or your speech is not factually correct? It doesn't matter. The second thing is, of course, you must preferably read widely, which not many people do these days, I suppose. And if your language and your vocabulary skills are reasonably average, you should have no problems coming up here to speak on table topics. And why do you think table topics is important? I find it very, very productive to learn table topics rather than the project speeches. I mean, I'm not saying project speeches are not important. They are your building blocks to make you a very competent communicator. But table topics is very helpful for many of us, particularly those of us who are working. Because sometimes when you are slotted in to give a speech, or you have KPIs to do because you have to follow speeches according to certain deadlines, you may not have the time to prepare for speeches. You may not have the time to rehearse a speech 101 times. I mean, there are Toastmasters I know who practice a speech over 100 times. You can only do that if you have no other thing to do except Toastmasters. It's not easy. It's very challenging for a lot of working people. So table topics is good in the sense that it trains you to be very disciplined in the way you think, how to organize your thoughts all in your head, then with that confidence that you have built, you just deliver a speech that is only 1 minute long. Because some clubs, they always talk about 2 minutes. 1 minute is the minimum time you need to speak. That's it. So it cannot be difficult to talk for 60 seconds. Think about it. And I learned to be where I am today because I developed my impromptu speaking skills. That means I must have lots of confidence to come up and speak on any topic. So today, if you see me going around different Toastmasters meetings and doing probably 2 to 3 speeches a week, it's because I have learned to develop impromptu speaking in my head. But then I have advanced to a different level where I can speak, not just 1 to 2 minutes, I can speak a normal speech length, which is 5 to 7 minutes. That is the benefit that you get. And that is to demonstrate to yourself where you are as a speaker. Because, okay, this is an in-house club, so I'm not sure what are your motives in joining Zuelik Parma Shahlan Postmasters Club, unless you say you are forced to, which is possible. But really, if you are ready to open your minds and open your hearts and embrace the learning, there's a lot to learn in Postmasters. You must understand the purpose of Postmasters. It's not just about communication, it's just not about leadership, but it's more about self-confidence. That no matter what mood you're in, or whether you're tired, or mentally exhausted, or physically exhausted, you can still come up here and deliver a speech that you are happy about. Now, because it's a mini speech, it's about developing your mind and introduction. So a topic like, say, my happiest day in my life, it's just picking a topic. So you can start with storytelling, you can start with a joke, you can give an anecdote, you can even start off with a quotation. So anything goes insofar as introduction is concerned. The idea is to catch people's attention, so that people want to listen to you for 1 or 2 minutes. Of course, in Toastmasters meeting, it's a lot easier, because when you speak up there, everybody is forced to listen. Although, of course, listening is not necessarily active listening. Some of you may be looking at me, your ears are hearing me, but you may not actually be listening. Just by thinking about your wife, you may be thinking about dinner, thinking about when will this meeting end so I can go back. It's been a long day. But it is important to learn. And I encourage you to take part in table topics, because that's how you measure yourself, in what kind of confidence that you have built in yourself so that you can come up. Do all the things that you're learning in the computer communication manual and speak. It doesn't matter if you make mistakes. It doesn't matter if you falter. It doesn't matter if you get stuck halfway. It's about pushing yourself. And that is another reason why we are all in Toastmasters. It's about pushing the boundaries. Every meeting we go to, we try to learn something. If we can leave this room having learned something, just one thing, you would have grown as a Toastmaster. And even if you're not feeling great about being a Toastmaster, believe me, you take those small, steady steps, one day I guarantee you, you will appreciate the lessons that you learn as a Toastmaster. I do. I mean, that's why I always say I want to lead Toastmasters, because it's getting very tiring and expensive. But I'm still here, because Toastmasters is about lifelong learning. So table topics, whenever there's a session in a meeting, go for it. Just speak. As long as you speak with sincerity, it doesn't matter whether you're on the topic, or over the topic, or under the topic, or around the topic. Nobody cares. It's about building confidence. That's the first reason why you try to do table topics. And you yourself want to know whether you are confident or not. So how to measure that confidence? We're all working people. We know our KPIs. We want to look at measurement instruments whenever we do something in the corporate world. So in Toastmasters, it's about table topics. You can come up here and speak for 1 minute, and you get a decent evaluation. That's your KPI. That says that, hey, I have done what I've done, and it produced a fair result. And if you do it often, I guarantee you become better. Because speaking is about speaking and speaking and speaking and speaking. The more you speak, the more you become fluent in your language, the more you become fluid in your presentation. You don't have to start wondering, okay, what's the next word, how to make this next sentence, because you have practiced every time you do your table topic session, every time you do your speeches. That's one of the reasons why I do 2 or 3 speeches a week. And it helps. But it requires you to be disciplined, requires you to believe in yourself that you can do it, and you are looking for a challenge in Toastmasters. Unless you come here just for the free food, just to be seen to be a member, just attend and laugh and listen, that's it. Then of course, you will benefit. But you come here wanting to learn something, table topics can help you. Now, I noticed there's no session for table topics, so I can't do a demo, but maybe I can do a demo. I can get somebody to volunteer. Can anybody want to volunteer? I'll just give a topic, simple topic, don't worry. Okay. Yay. See, that is already courageous of her to come out, volunteer, and it doesn't matter what she speaks on. It doesn't really matter how well she speaks on. The fact that she's up here, she's ready to deliver a speech for 1 minute, that's courage for you. And that is something the Toastmasters that we respect. Because in Toastmasters, we are not paid for anything. We do it voluntarily. So it's about recognition. Fact that she can come up and we recognize her for her courage, that's what I'll give you a topic. Okay? My most awkward moment.
My most awkward moment, it will be like 12 years ago when all my boyfriends all in the same location at the same time, and they are supposed to be a different day for me to meet up with them. Okay. I have 7 days in a week, so Saturday, Sunday, I will prefer to have a day for myself, which I already allocate Monday for someone from Air Force, Tuesday for someone from Navy, third will be policeman, fourth will be a custom officer, and fifth will be a guy from Bomba.
Wow.
They are attending a same seminar in KL, which they did not notify me because I always told them I couldn't see you on Tuesday because I got my own thing. Couldn't see you on Wednesday because I got my own thing. So happened to be all of them know each other actually.
Oh.
That's the worst part. Imagine that I attending the seminar looking for another 5 new boyfriend, then I have to meet up with the current 5 that I want to ditch. And they was happily chit-chatting with each other. Then the moment, the silent moment was like, you know her? You know her? You know her? Oh. That means number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and it's soon going to be the exes. So that's the most awkward moment for me actually. Because they are all the men in the security line. So imagine how I was like sweating and thinking what my way out from that situation. That's all.
Thank you. How easy is it for her? She is a relatively new Toastmaster. And she was very quick to take up that challenge. And she spoke well. She infused humor. She explained, and we can visualize that awkwardness, all 5 boyfriends in the same room that she is about to ditch and find new boyfriends and stuck. That's great. Now let's have one more. It's very easy. Come on, one more.
Yay!
My ideal man. Can be your husband. Okay, somebody other than your husband. You're better. Okay.
Hi, everybody. Okay, my ideal man. I have somebody in mind actually before I married my husband. But he just didn't come around after 20 years we have been together. But at last he got married met by a mom and dad, which was told to me later about the 23rd year. So I was thinking that that's it, the end of my life, which I was thinking is the only man, because I fall in love at first sight. And I start myself by being a singer, previously in year 1987. So I met lots of men, and well, I met my husband, which he came to the hotel, and we met, and about a year, we got married. So now he's my very high person in life.
Thank you.
Three,
okay. How many speeches have you done? One. Thank you very much.
Sorry.
In terms of your project speeches and your computer competition manual. Okay. Because obviously you are more at ease with speaking, I think. And she is still pretty, a little bit self-conscious. So when you stand here, you see that you put your hands in the back and you speak in measured tone. So, but still you demonstrated a lot of courage. I thought it was a very good mini speech. Something that's relatable, particularly for women who want to look for your ideal partner. Yeah. And I thought that's good. Perhaps the area of improvement I could give in that area, perhaps the second speaker you could move a little bit more, feel a bit more relaxed. Because you remind me like a school girl at school, you know. Attention. And it's good to just feel relaxed. Because always remember, the audience want to support you, want to root for you. So feel at ease. That's the best way, because when you feel at ease, you speak better. But both speeches I noticed are, well, good. Perhaps the other area of improvement, at some future time, you might want to incorporate speech value. What do you want to teach or tell us? Say maybe, you know, like the first speaker, five boyfriends, you want to teach, find another five boyfriends, then. Man, they're all the same. One or five or ten doesn't really matter. So if you lose one, you can always get another fish in the ocean, or another fish, Yeah? Second one, maybe the moral of the story is date as many as you can. You'll never know when you find one. He will come sooner or later. Yeah? Or something like that. So there's always speech value. So as you do that often, remembering that you have an introduction, a body with one or two points, supported with one or two anecdotes, and the conclusion, some speech value, and you've got a fantastic table topic. So it is very easy. Just keep it simple. Table topics is not scary. Just get your mind to embrace table topics. Some of us, we lose the battle when we come up here because of table topics. If I don't know the topic, how? I feel so embarrassed. Your mind has already had a difficulty. If you are positive, you try your level best, you have done well. No matter what the evaluator says, it doesn't matter. You yourself will feel good because you can stand up here, speak for at least 1 minute, that is all that matters. Over time, you will build that confidence to be a better speaker. So when you do your project speeches, also not much of a problem because you can already do table topics. What is project speeches? That is what I want to encourage you. Always try table topics. Not only the bravest. Everybody can do it. Just follow it all. Okay? So that's my little thing on improv speaking.